Hello, I'm Urologist Ömür Erdem Akkaya. Today I am here to shed some light on herpes virus type 2. As a urologist, I come across many cases where wounds on the penis are caused by herpes virus. Hence, I feel it is important to discuss this topic and educate people about the virus. What is herpes virus? Herpes virus is a type of microbe that is primarily transmitted through sexual contact. Upon entering the body, the virus travels to the nerves and remains dormant for a period of time. However, environmental and stress factors can cause the virus to reactivate, resulting in the formation of small, painful blisters that can eventually burst and turn into open sores or wounds. These wounds can be extremely uncomfortable and painful, and in severe cases, may even require the patient to stop sexual activity. So, how do we diagnose herpes virus? Usually, we diagnose herpes virus by clinical eye observing method. And what should be done? To further elaborate, diagnosing herpes virus can be challenging since its symptoms can be confused with those of other sexually transmitted diseases like syphilis and chancroid. Therefore, laboratory tests are necessary to confirm the diagnosis. However, it is worth noting that syphilis and chancroid are now rarely seen. Moving on to the treatment aspect, unfortunately, there is no effective vaccine treatment available for herpes virus. Furthermore, there is no drug treatment that can permanently remove the virus from the body. However, the good news is that antiviral treatment methods are available and can create an effective treatment plan. Another significant problem associated with the herpes virus is that it can cause urethritis, which is the inflammation of the urethra. It is responsible for 5-15% of gonorrhea cases. It is important to note that herpes and gonorrhea does not present with an obvious discharge, but instead, patients may experience a burning sensation during urination and may have swells in the groin area. Giving antibiotics for an ordinary gonorrhea infection will not be effective in treating herpes virus. Instead, only antiviral treatments can help the patient recover. One of the most common concerns that patients with herpes virus have is that they cannot get rid of it and may transmit it to their partners. However, even though the virus cannot be completely removed from the body, our immune system suppresses it and prevents it from causing an infection. In a person with a normal immune system, the risk of the virus causing an infection is only 1%. However, if the immune system is suppressed due to another disease, then the risk can be between 4% to 6%. Thank you for watching my video, and please do subscribe to my channel for more informative videos.